$1,000, which is approximately 115 days accounts payable. Our net assets at the end of October 31st, 2009, were $364,000. Quickly, that goes through the interest statement. For the month of October, we had a loss before depreciation and amortization of $1.3 million and a total loss of $1.9 million. On a year-to-date basis, our loss before depreciation and amortization was approximately $7 million, with a total loss of $13 million. And I don't know if this is where we talked about the mix. I mean, one of the things that we had, that we saw, which was unusual for October, or for the results appear to be unusual, is we had such a robust month in terms of volume. If you look at our volume, and starting in the tax was included, we had 867 discharges in the month of October. That's 90 more than we experienced last year for the month of October. However, our net patient service revenue is down. And that's being driven by two factors. One, we've seen an increase in our uninsured patients. Our uninsured patients averaged last year in 2008 approximately 12%. In 2009, in October of 2009, they were about 17.4% of our payer mix. We believe that this change in payer mix has to do with an increase in the unemployed population, those folks who were unemployed, and those folks who, you know, whose unemployment and COBRA, now their COBRA has run out. The other thing driving the reduction in that patient service revenue was a change in our case mix index. We experienced the second lowest case mix index we've experienced all year, Medicare case mix index. The Medicare case mix index was 1.09, and I believe that's budgeted to be about 1.28. So the combination of a low CMI along with change in care suppressed our revenues for the month of October, thus largely driving the operating costs.
Let me tie that into what I said before about the recovery plan. You know, the financials this month are not great, but they're not worse, and that's sort of a little bit of a tough subject to, you know, maybe a little hard to understand what I mean by it, but I'll explain shortly. They're not worse than they have been, in the sense that if you look back and you look at the audit adjustment that was down to 2008, you know, some of the financials look better because of the way revenue was being reported, but if you take those audit adjustments and you apply them to the year, essentially, you know, this is a sort of an average month, even for ages. So, while that's not good news, I want to point out this is not, you know, suddenly we have a worse month. It's sort of like what sort of was happening apparently for a while, and it wasn't quite coming to the surface because of the way the revenue was being recorded. Having said that, you know, I want to tie it back to the $12 million I was talking about before. The recovery plan that we're putting together involved a $12 million gap closure, you know, on our end, plus the assistance from the state, because frankly, you know, we have debts that we want to start repaying and replenishing accounts, and we have folks that we owe money to, vendors that need to be paid. So if you look at the annual number, right now the loss from operations is shy of $7 million, $7.8 and change. We have said that we anticipate to close the year somewhere in the $8 to $8.5 million loss in operation, which is about half or less than half than last year. And I think that number is still doable. For November and December, we're still shooting to do that. When you add the interest expense, and not, I'm talking about not cash outlays, you add the interest expense to that, on an annual basis, you get to about $11 to $12 million. That's really where the, and I think some people objected to my use of the word bucks. It's too casual. Okay, dollars. I put it somewhere else. So $4 million is really
I just remember that. I saw it somewhere.
I also saw that I made a big mistake. So the point is that $12 million is really the gap that you see on an annual basis, and that's the number that we're targeting in 2010. Just wanted to tie that recovery plan into this so you see how it works out.
Yeah. 2008 audit, AuditorW issued a letter of recommendation that required us to submit a corrective action plan. I think that last board meeting said that we submit that to this board meeting, and I think that was included in the package.
Yes.
There were 10 findings altogether. I'm going to go through them relatively quickly unless you have a question. The first finding was that there was no prior year formal corrective action plan. That has been addressed by filing of this corrective action plan. That will be addressed by December 31st of 2009. The second finding talks about a cash management plan and for the hospital, we're looking for hospital authority, and we spoke about that during the finance committee, and I think we come up with a plan with having to go with George and resting a plan to be submitted by the end of the first quarter of 2010. Again, finding number three, no surety bonds for the utility assets will also be addressed by the end of the first quarter of 2010. The fourth finding has to do with policy and procedure manuals, and it requires us to update our policy and procedure manuals on a more timely basis. We had originally slated an implementation date for that to be the second quarter of 2010. However, after discussion with the finance committee, we agreed that we have targeted the end of the first quarter of 2010 to have our policy and procedures updated. We also, finding number five, updated the compliance program, and that addresses the compliance program that we have in place relative to the OIG's compliance plan, or plan that they file each year. And we will have our plan in place to address the OIG's plan by the end of the first quarter of 2010. The sixth finding has to do with account analysis, and the auditors are requesting us to perform our account analysis in a more timely fashion. We have been doing that on an ongoing basis throughout 2009, and expect to have that also completed prior to December 31st, 2009. The seventh finding has to do with audit adjustments. And what the auditors are asking us to do is to be more judicial in our preparation of journal entries, review and oversight of the preparation of journal entries, and to make sure that we perform analysis on a more timely basis. That will be implemented by December 31st, 2009. The finding number eight has to do with periodic payments, or interim payments, or open as PIP. And we are in the process of reconciling our PIP account. We have made some progress and have also made some adjustments to those accounts. That reconciliation should and will be completed by the first quarter of 2010 to coincide with the audit for 2009. The ninth finding has to do with amounts, uncollectibles, and write-offs. And the auditors are recommending that we change our methodology so as to avoid a year-end entry of the magnitude that we experienced in 2008. We agree with this recommendation. The implementation date on the corrective action plan says it's for the end of the first quarter of 2010, or what I think we will be able to achieve is by December 31st, 2009. And the last finding has to do with cash drawdowns, and that has been implemented, and was implemented on August 31st, 2009.
Thanks, Ben, and thanks for your help.